So, pretty intense times, everybody. I wanted to just tune in and let everybody know that it's pretty intense times right now. And if anybody else is like me, a human being, it's painful what we're all feeling right now as a collective. I think it's appropriate for me to just pop on really quick and explain what I'm feeling as far as the energies are concerned with the moon where it is right now, which is in Capricorn. And while I do that, I'm going to create a wholesome meal because I feel like the most powerful thing that I can do is just show up again and share how I use astrology to transmute difficult energies like the times that we're dealing with right now. And Annie, since you are here, can you just tell me, is the music too loud? Is it okay volume? Let me know. And then while I am cooking, please feel free to interact. I just want to pop on, share some of these really delicious things that I found at the farmer's market today in Mueller, which are these delicious trumpet mushrooms, while we go through some of these energies, because I feel like food is one of the things that we can connect to across all sorts of different cultures. And for me, I feel that mushrooms are such a good replacement for anybody who's trying to find something like really hearty and meaty. These are what you want. So I picked these up from Hi-Fi Myco today at the farmer's market in Mueller. And so they come, you can just buy them per pound or whatever, but you can also purchase a starter kit and actually grow them at home, which is pretty awesome. And so as far as this one is concerned, he actually had already, it started producing fruit and sold me this starter kit so that I can actually take this trumpet mushroom off of the block and then it keep it wet and watered, and then it will actually produce another fruit, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to show you how I take these off, and let's see. So when you're making the steak for every single trumpet mushroom clump that you get, you're gonna get more, like every single one of these layers acts as a marbling to the meat, if you will. So when you're taking these off, what you're gonna wanna do is like chunk it in, keep it in a chunk if you can. So I'm just gonna try to gently pull this apart. And actually, I'm going to use a knife. I wanted to look at it just to make sure that I couldn't pull it apart, but I feel like doing a knife would be better. So let's see. So I'm just going to slide the knife right along this edge, just making sure to not get any plastic in here as I do this. And then I also am going to see if you guys can see this down here. So since these are a little bit tougher than I thought they were going to be, I'm going to use a serrated knife. Because I was expecting them to be a little bit more fragile, but these guys are actually pretty on there. Nice. So just one big clump. And I actually probably could have kept this one on there as well. No! Next time I will do better. First time's a charm for everything, right? Usually not, but sometimes you get lucky. These are gonna be so good. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's see. I'm just setting these aside. Let's see. I want to see if I can just break it off instead. Nice. Cool. Okay. So there's the whole chunk. Okay, so then with this, what I'm going to do is just put it on a dish. And then what the farmer told me to do was to put some newspaper under this. I'm just going to spray it with some water, and then we are good to go on that. So I'm pretty excited about seeing how quickly these things sprout another fruit. Okay, so now that those are here, I'm just going to take these and set these aside. Okay, so then what we're going to do with these are going to be actually put in barbecue sauce. I've got a couple of dry ingredients that I'm going to use as a rub that I'm going to sprinkle over the mushrooms themselves. I'm also going to do some mashed potatoes, and we're gonna chop up some vegetables, get some garlic going, so let's see how this goes. All right, everybody, had a little bit of technical difficulty with the connection. I got cut off. I went ahead and actually sped through some of the recipes so that it would save us a little bit of time so we could spend more time talking about the astrology. I will just let you know that the vent has to be on for this recipe, so sorry about the extra noise. I will post this video to IGTV later if the sound quality isn't horrible, but I just will take you over here to what it is that we are doing with the vegetables. And then we'll go ahead and get into some of this astrology. So right now I've just got some zucchini and carrots going. I've got the trumpet mushrooms sitting over there ready for me to put in this very hot pan of oil that is getting ready for me so that I can get these mushrooms in here, which is why the vent needs to be on. So I'm sorry about the background noise. So now that this pan is definitely super hot, I'm going to go ahead and put in these trumpet mushrooms now. So you want them, you don't need to put anything on them. You're going to want to squish them though so that all the water comes out. And you want to get this side of it down. So. This is the magical part, is that you're going to want to press them. You want to have an even surface area around the whole thing. Another cast iron is the best thing to have on it, but I don't have something like that, so I've done it before and this works just fine. But you really want to press and squeeze so that all of the water gets out of it. And then I've got the zucchini over there, which looks like it needs to be flipped. Potatoes going as well. And so I have more zucchini great location because they have a big lake, so if you want to go and hang out there, that's a fun place to go while you're trying to de-stress from everything going on right now. So getting into some of those energies, we can go there now. I want to go back to like March and even before that, December. And the reason for that is because we had the eclipse, the last set of eclipses we had were in December. And those were in the axis of Cancer and Capricorn. Cancer and Capricorn. If you want to go to any videos that I have put out on astrology, I've been putting out a lot lately. And these are actually getting ready to flip, I have a feeling, here. Alright, so you want to get them to the point where they're nice and golden brown. And then go ahead and give them a flip. And you'll also want to make sure that the pan stays nice and oiled the whole time, too. This is just the initial browning. There's going to be more flipping coming. So I'm going to go ahead and add some olive oil now to this. And with that, you know, this is a hard recipe to substitute with water, but you can. You can do this with water, but you're going to lose a lot of the fatty quality that happens when you mix the mushroom with the flavor of the fats, of, like the tongue feel. During Christmas, and now we're having another set of eclipses, and hey, I'm seeing who just joined. Thank you for joining. I'm just talking a little astrology while we're making some mushroom magic here, and just bringing up the last eclipses that we had, which were in the Christmas season, and now we're going to, we just had the next set of eclipses that are starting, which is Sagittarius and Gemini energy. So we just had that yesterday, and now we are moving towards a completely different energy spectrum, and so I felt like it was good timing to just come on and explain like why all of this collective energy is showing up for us, and the reason why it's showing up for us is it's giving us all an opportunity to look within, is how I feel. So the reason why I feel like that is because I use astrology to understand how I can play a role in the bigger scheme of things. I mean, right now, the problem that we're all facing right now isn't just, one group's fight. I mean, this is like, you know, equality and justice is something that we are all, living in order to experience. So the reason why I wanted to bring up the eclipses is because this is just one set of eclipses that we're about to have, and then we're going to have another set of eclipses that follow this in another 2 weeks. And so the eclipses that we're going to have in 2 weeks is actually going to be in that Cancer Capricorn axis again. And so Cancer Capricorn is really representative of the home and the mother. Energy, which is where the moon is now. an opportunity to remember. So 6 months ago was when we had these last set of eclipses, and now we're about to have 2 weeks before we have another set of eclipses in the same one, in the same axis that we had during the Christmas time period. So, you know, a lot of work has been done, and if we remember what was going on during the Christmas time period, it was like all this energy asking us to stay home and to do work and to think about how we can exchange value with one another in a more meaningful way. So as far as that is concerned, you know, we are going to have to flip this. So hold on 1 second. This is getting to the point where it needs to be flipped. Like I was saying about the eclipse energies that we're experiencing, this is a great time to be making huge changes like we are. And so when we're thinking about where the moon is right now and where it's been, I wanted to just talk about the fact that we had, after the eclipses, we had a series of new moons and full moons, obviously, that follow that. And right now, I want to just mention that we had that new moon in Gemini, and that was on May 22nd. And that new moon in Gemini was foreshadowing the energies that we're experiencing, you know, with this eclipse that we just had the other day. And so we think about, you know, the moon going from Gemini, and then over the weekend it shifted into Cancer that Sunday, and then it stayed in Cancer all the way until the 27th, and then over the weekend it shifted into Virgo. And this is where I wanted to just get to is, so I'm just going to add this to the rest of this one. So with the energies being in Virgo, which as I'm mixing this up, it's all about the alchemist. Like, that's what Virgo energy is all about and represents. So that Virgo energy is also representative of discernment. And I feel like we had a lot of energy that we had to decipher through and discern over the weekend, especially as things escalated with, you know, now we're not only facing a pandemic as far as like health is concerned, but now, you know, we're reminded again of the fact that there's so much inequality that exists in our world. And so, you know, that's really what's going on right now. So this is like a human being conflict that we all face is all of these energies that we're dealing with. So, you know, on a collective level, we're seeing it play out to where, you know, people's lives are actually, you know, being put on display in this way. But individually in your own space, I'm sure that you're also feeling this in a way. So I'm just going to sprinkle this on here now. You want to be pretty generous with it, because it's just going to fill in energy that we've been experiencing over the weekend, you know, it's been pretty intense, and we've been experiencing, you know, the actual injustices in, on display, and people protesting all over the world, coming together, and then, you know, justice was kind of starting to become served, and, you know, sentences were changing and stuff, and that was all over this Libra energy. And then from the Libra energy, we shifted out of Libra and went into the Sagittarius energy, the Scorpio energy. And with the Scorpio energy, stuff got real. Like, this has just been, like, a really intense time. And, you know, it's been this transformative time as well, because Scorpio really represents the phoenix rising from the ashes, and really this symbol of this cycle of life, the sex, death, and rebirth, like the triality. And so, you know, this week, you know, that happened on the second on Tuesday, when the moon shifted into Scorpio. And then we had the moon move into Sagittarius on the 4th and stay with us until Saturday it switched into Capricorn. And so the difference between the moon being in Scorpio, and gotta pepper this again, so let's just bring this down here. Or season it, rather. It's a little bit blacker than I wanted it, but it's okay. It will turn out delicious. As far as having the moon now being in Capricorn, it's a really good time to, with the moon being in Sagittarius, we took that transformation and then actually did the spiritual philosophical work where we get Sagittarius energy, which is the wise sage, and he takes the energy into the collective, and that is such an important thing to do for everybody right now. Like, no matter how small we are, we have an individual soul purpose here, and so bringing it forward is the most important thing that we can do, and sharing it however that means for you. So now that this moving into Capricorn, we're being pushed to share with the collective in a different way. We have the government coming in and restricting energies, and you know, that's the job of Capricorn, is to restrict, and it is the governments, and it is the rules and laws and regulations. And so, you know, we as a people get to decide how much we put up with that, but at the same time, it's necessary. We need, you know, the state involved. And so, you know, the job of the state is to protect the mother. So, you know, without, you can't have one without the other. So, you know, coming together as a human being with another human being, that is what the 10th energy represents. How do you care here on planet Earth? That's the 10th house energy of Capricorn. So, you know, we're going to be moving into this Aquarian energy on Monday, and that stays with us until Thursday. And so that energy is this new energy of us coming together as a collective. Like, what do we want it to look like? Right now, this is what my collective experience looks like. I'm going to add some barbecue sauce to this, and then we'll see it right here. This is Stubbs barbecue sauce. So this whole thing, this whole meal was all local, which is something that I've been striving towards, and trying to find local products and local community to connect to during, you know, this time. And I feel like that's something that all of us could do to support one another right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take these mushrooms and slather this good stuff all over it. So we'll just go like this. So where we're going to go now is I'm going to just mash up these mashed potatoes. We've got some barbecue trumpet mushrooms going. We've got some grilled vegetables, or baked rather. And now I'm going to mash these mashed potatoes up. So my favorite trick for doing this without a strainer is using the lid and then letting the water steam out. So it's basically like that. Some plant-based butter. If you guys need a brand recommendation on that, that is going to be this right here. So let's see. So now that we've got this boiling, what I'm going to do here, and what these are, if you're just joining us, these are actually trumpet mushrooms. So they turn into this like deliciously meaty, gorgeous food if you prepare them correctly. So if you're just tuning in with me, then you'll have to come back to the IG live that I post later. And we're also talking about astrology and how it can help to understand what's going on right now in the collective, having an astrological perspective. So I was just talking about how Capricorn right now is where the moon is, and it's asking us to, you know, understand how the state plays its role. But we're also going to be experiencing energies moving into Capricorn, or into Aquarius soon, and that is going to be giving us the opportunity to Oh, good night. Thank you. I appreciate you staying on and checking in. Have a good night's sleep. So let's see. So we're going to just make some mashed potatoes really quick, was where I was going with that. Let me do that, and then I'll come back to the astrology. Okay. So the Aquarian age is like what we've all been manifesting. Like, this is this new time that has been approaching, and Mars and Saturn moved into Aquarius back in March. Mars is going to be actually moving into Aries soon, so we're past that. Mars has been in Pisces now for a while, and what all that means is that we got the opportunity back in March to start thinking about how to use technology in a way to really just interact with one another differently. And, you know, with all this like stay-at-home business, we got the opportunity maybe to really question like what we were going to work for and what we were spending our time on. And so I feel that, you know, with this energy that we're going to have for the next couple of days in Aquarius, we can really maybe put some energy towards finding community in technologically advancing ways. So whether that for you means that you're a small business and you have been working on creating a website, or whether that means that you have gotten to find new clients from really surprising and different new ways, like maybe new referrals coming in from a different source that you didn't expect. Like, there's lots of different ways to interpret that energy, and this is why like using your birth chart lined up to where everything is right now is so important. So if that's something that you're interested in, that's something that I offer, you can go to holistichealing.coach to check that out. And I'm going to just, now I've got some butter in here, it's already melted. I'm just going to give this a little squish here. This usually has enough, let's see, like 3 tablespoons of butter is usually enough. I'm gonna add just a little bit more here. And let's see, now that that's done, we can turn this off. I also love oatly milk, it's my favorite. If you haven't tried it, it's delicious. So a little bit of milk in there to make it nice and creamy. And then we'll also want to do salt and pepper with these guys. Okay, so as far as then we're going to have this energy going into Pisces, the moon energy moving into Pisces, and that energy will allow us to get into more of this dream state and maybe be able to find solutions that we didn't know existed for us in this moment for whatever reason. So that would be a good time to, you know, get in touch with your artistic nature side if you haven't, you know, done anything artistic, because the energies of Pisces is really, really loves to get out of the boundaries of this physical domain, and one of the best ways of doing that is art. That's something else that I also mentioned is how transformative art has been for me in my life, especially processing difficult things like we're facing now. So basically, dinner is done now. We're just gonna plate all this up, and I will go ahead and send you guys some pictures of what it all looks like later on. I know that these are difficult times for everybody. I know that nothing is easy. I know that I don't have any of the answers, but I know what works for me to get through difficult times every day, and that's why I wanted to come and share it with you. So I hope that it's been a little bit of, you know, just kind of understanding that, you know, these energies are bigger than you, and so that's why it feels so overwhelming. So just do what you can do, and that is the best thing that you can do, because when, you know, part of the reason why we're seeing all this conflict outside of us is because there's a conflict that exists within each one of us that we aren't dealing with, and then we take it out into our daily lives, and then that is where all of this conflict and war happens. You know, with the energy being in Capricorn, it's also a good time to just talk about the fact that, you know, this inner conflict that we have, it doesn't get settled by going out and trying to, you know, have somebody else figure out your problem for you. You've got to take the initiative and do what you have to do in order to build yourself back up. And so, you know, there's a lot of blaming that's getting thrown around right now, and, you know, the economy is going into collapse, and, you know, but at the same time, all of this is happening for a reason. And if you're feeling like you know, you don't have the solutions right now, this is the time to create one for yourself, a new solution. Like, if I know that this is also difficult because there's, you know, there's no way to expect or predict the unpredictable. So you just have to take the information that you have in this moment now and then take the next step forward in the day ahead of you. So there are no answers. I don't have any. I'm just going to keep talking and trying to fill up space with something that feels like a good wrap-up point. But how about there is no wrap-up point. I'll just send some pictures of my food later. Thanks for joining me, you guys. Talk soon again. Bye.